Hello, I'd like to show you how to set up your gradebook so you can have a running total of the score displayed as a percentage to your students. So, as you can see, this is just a blank course that's been created for this, and I'm going to go into the gradebook and create some grades. Okay, we have a couple of students enrolled. So I'll go to the categories and items to start adding some items to the grade book. I go down at the bottom here to add a grade item. Note that this is set to sum of grades at this point, and this is a key setting that we'll have to change. Sum of grades presents the points in a cumulative fashion, so it will add the points up as they go along and not display a percentage total, which is what we want to do here. So the first thing we'll do is we'll change that to simple weighted mean of grades, and then we'll start adding items. Okay, we'll call this assignment 1, and we'll give it a maximum grade of 10 points. I'm going to keep the grade book very simple here. Make it add up to 100. That way it's very easy for the students to calculate their own scores. Obviously there can be some variation in those numbers, but I'll keep things simple. Assignment 3, I'll make this 10 points too. A second. There we go. Let's add something a little bit different here. We'll call it a paper one. Okay, and we'll make that 10 as well. We're starting to populate that gradebook now. And if I didn't fill in the maximum grade there, I can always change it in this screen here, in this area, in this maximum grade. But I must remember to click Save. Okay, let's have a discussion or two. I'll keep that simple too for demonstration purposes. Discussion 2. Okay. Well, let's throw in a project worth a little bit more than 10 points. Okay, I'll make it 20. And a presentation. Okay, so just looking at this now, I think we have 100 there, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 90, 100. And then it's important to include the course total here as 100 if you want to have that percentage recognized. So once you have that, click Save Changes. Okay, so let me go to view the gradebook now. And we'll see that the two students don't have any grades yet. So what I'll do is I'll turn editing on to add those grades. And let's give a 9 and an 8. And this is where you add it, and a tab will let you go down easily. This is for feedback if you want to add some quick comments there. And you can also use this for more detailed feedback. Okay, we'll go 9, 8 throughout. And they haven't done assignment 3 yet, so they've got assignment paper 1. They've done discussion 1. We can pretend. And they've done their group project. This is out of 20, so 19, 19, and I don't suppose it matters, so let's give him a 9 and an 8 for this presentation. Okay, then we'll update it. So we should now see a course total in our view, and sometimes it's easier to view this if you turn editing off. So you can see 9 and 8 out of 10, 9 and 8 out of 10, 9 and 8 out of 10, 19, 18 out of 20, course total is presented here. If you want to view what the students see, you click on User Report, and nothing is presented initially when you click on this screen. You have to select all or one user. So if you choose this, you can see all users, or you can just select an individual student. Let's choose all users. Okay, so there are the grades, the points, and this is the percentage for each of those items, and the course total displayed as a percentage. So that is how to set up the gradebook with a simple weighted mean of grades to give you that percentage course total. Just as a note, the calculation, 91.43% there, it is based on and the addition of all of those points, 9, 9, 9, 19 and 9, divided by the maximum total points that the student could have had. So they could have had, in this case, 70 points, and they had a total of 64. So 64 divided by 70 is 91.43%. Okay, thank you.